side of things. Propel, Mr. Lion's here, and he's going to be doing some fast drawing for you. I know you're going to enjoy it. You know who else is going to stop by? Ooh. Grandma Nellie and all my other pals. I'll tell you, what I'd like you to do right now is to park the Bozo.
Those were wonderful days when Bozo the Clown dressed up from head to toe and entertained the children all over New England. The man we have to thank for those wonderful days is Frank Avrish, and we're grateful to him. And we'll go to Frank now with a face that's also very, very familiar, a face that inspired him and the Bozo character he created. Frank?
Talk about memories, Tim. I can't tell you what a strange feeling it is right now. Of course, this is an opportunity for me to finally set the record straight. As many people in New England know, I did Bozo for 12 years, and I stopped doing it in 1970. But there is a man who actually did it longer than that, and in fact is still doing it. He owns the rights to Bozo. His name is Larry Harmon, and he's here right now with us. Hi, Larry.
Oh, howdy, Frank.
Give me a whoa, Nellie. Give me a
whoa, Nellie.
Oh, I don't know. I had trepidations about doing it. Now, of course, the character was terrific, and I really enjoyed it, except there's only one thing. After all this time, I'm really going to confront you with it. It took me around the world. I did all those trips for UNICEF and the United Nations, all those things.
Yeah.
Syndicated all over the country.
Right.
Did the show here, big show. But the only thing I never got was a piece of the action, Larry. That's the only thing. You know what we call, you know...
You know what? I think my battery just went down.
This guy, and if Arthur Miller is listening, he'd be very proud of me, owns the rights to Bozo in perpetuity. That means, I don't know how many years ago, he bought the rights from Capitol Records for anything that, so all the Bozo dolls and Bozo cups and all the royalties go to you.
Well,
that's amazing.
35 years ago on television, started in about 1950 or so when I created Bozo for television. Of course, you see, I did in California, which you were just talking about. I started it. It was all me. Here I was doing Bozo the Clown. I created the cartoons, and then I sold it to Paramount Television. Yeah. And then the next thought I got was about how could I perpetuate that? How could I become a duplication of myself all over the world? That was the key. The light bulb went on. And that's probably when I was starting to be a doctor at USC. I was studying the medicine.
It's a far cry from being a doctor to going into this.
But think about it. I wanted to be a doctor with patients, but I thought, why couldn't I be a doctor of laughter, a doctor of love, a doctor of understanding? And that's how the light bulb went on. Bozo was created. I started in Hollywood, and then I came to Boston. And I said, I have to, the Statler Hotel, you probably remember.
Yeah.
I said, I need somebody here. I'll share how we'll do the show. They said, who? I found you? I said, how about him? He says, how about him? Okay. I said, hello, we liked each other. I trained you as Bozo. That was it. The rest was history.
Tell the truth. Was I the best one that ever did it? I mean, you can tell it now. Go ahead. Tell the truth.
Now, yeah.